Hey guys, today I'm going to be trying two new onigiris, and one is pretty traditional and one is shin hatsubai, which means it is brand new. Now the triangle one is kombu, which is kelp, and it is flavored with soy and a little bit of sugar, I'm assuming. I'm not sure what all is in it, but it's really good. I'll be showing you guys in a second. Now this one is really weird. It says it's like ramen rice, and basically what it has is a flavored egg in it. And I'm not sure what flavor the rice is. I'll be trying that out, but I just thought it was so weird to see like half of a soft-boiled egg in an onigiri, so I had to pick it up. Now, as always, this one cost 140 yen with tax, and this one cost 110 yen with tax. Okay, let's open up the kombu onigiri, and if you guys have not noticed, all of my onigiris are from 7-Eleven because I live pretty close to one. But I am interested in trying onigiri from different convenience stores. So we have one, two, and three. Voila! And our fresh seaweed. A perfect triangle. There we go. Ta-da! And this is kelp, which is basically a type of seaweed with a sweetened soy sauce, basically, and it's been stewed down, and it's really good. I like it a lot. I'm gonna go ahead and take a bite, and I mean, I already know I like it, but why not take a bite? It's really good. I'm more of a tuna mayonnaise person or salmon person, but kombu is really good too. Now, the main event, the soft-boiled egg, or flavored egg, omusubi. Let's open this up. What I'm curious about is how hard is this going to be to eat? Let's see. I guess I'll pop it out. Ooh, I see the mayonnaise. That is so weird. Can you guys see? The egg looks really nice though. I'm going to go ahead and take a bite. You can look at my half-eaten onigiri. The rice is a very mild flavor. It does have chunks of pork in it. And it's not, you know, as bland as normal white rice. It is very good. The egg is perfect. I love soft-boiled eggs, and well, this is not a runny egg. It is soft-boiled, and the flavor is perfect. Now, the mayonnaise may be overdoing it a little bit. I am okay with mayonnaise. I know there are people out there that don't like mayonnaise, but Japanese mayonnaise is pretty good, but it just is a little bit too much, too rich almost. I'd be okay without the mayonnaise, but the flavor is perfect. And it wasn't as messy to eat as I thought it would be. I think it's, you know, containable. It won't be dripping and dropping all over the place. It's very good. Now, would I buy this again? Probably not. When I want an onigiri, I usually go for the more simple ones, tuna mayonnaise, salmon, like I said. And I don't know, it just is too much. If I wanted something like this, I probably would go for an obento, a lunchbox, instead. But this is really, really good. It's definitely worth trying if you're in Japan or live in Japan, visiting Japan, you know, whatever, and happen to see one in the convenience store. The flavor is delicious, and I think probably anyone could eat this unless they're allergic to eggs or something. Then you might want to avoid it. But other than the mayonnaise, especially for people that don't like mayonnaise, I think this is an onigiri that, you know, almost anyone would like, but I don't know. Let me know what you thought of today's onigiri. The kombu onigiri is very delicious too. Let me know what types of onigiri you like to eat if you, you know, have a chance to buy onigiri, make onigiri, or what kinds of onigiri that you're interested in. And I'll keep my eyes open for more weird onigiris. I'll see you guys next time. Bye!